Hi, I'm Richard. I'm the director of Sergeant Stubby and American Hero.
Let's go. We've got a war to win.
To make a movie like this, you have to love a bunch of things. You've got to love dogs. You've got to love history. You've got to love storytelling, and you've got to love movies. I love all those things, and that's why I made this movie. This is a real inspirational zero-to-hero story. It's almost the American dream in canine form. When we decided to make the movie, we really had to do a lot of research, which involved visiting locations in France and the US, trawling through archives. I want to share this with you now as I take you on a journey following in Stubby's pawprints. To understand the story of Stubby, we first have to understand the war. The US didn't declare war until 1917. Before that, they'd really done their best to stay out of it altogether. But as time went by, and the German U-boats sank more ships in the Atlantic and interfered with the already difficult US-Mexican relationship, the United States had no choice but to get involved. But it really didn't have much of an army. And what army it did have was spread all along the Mexican border. National Guard units from all across the US were pressed into service. The Connecticut and Massachusetts National Guard were formed into the Yankee Division.
That's you, man. You're the Yankee Division. That includes you too, Stubby.
Our hero, Stubby, joined the 102nd Infantry Regiment of the Yankee Division as they trained on Yale campus in New Haven. We know nothing about Stubby before he was adopted, but by all accounts, as a homeless dog during the early part of the 20th century, it was a particularly tough life. The day he wandered onto the campus at Yale, we do know that his life changed forever.
Okay, Stubby, you're too quick for me, boy.
I've watched you men become soldiers. It makes me proud. Of you too, Stubby. Now, take this weekend to write your letters and say your farewells. We ship out Monday night. God bless us all, and God bless the United States of America.
It's hard to imagine what it was like for the citizen soldiers when they got the word it was time to go.
Stubby, come on. This is really hard for me too. You're going to be fine, and I will be back before you know it.
In overall command of American troops was General John J. Pershing, a veteran of the Spanish-American War.
3 years after Germany invaded France, both sides are bogged down in the trenches. Our General Pershing's gonna change all that. When we get there, we're gonna take the fight to the enemy.
They shipped out of Newport News, Virginia, on the USS Minnesota, a Connecticut-class battleship. It was part of the Great White Fleet that had sailed around the globe in 1909, to show the world that the US Navy was capable of worldwide travel. The Minnesota survived until 1921, when it was finally scrapped. But in 2013, a new Minnesota was launched, a Virginia-class nuclear attack submarine. We have no idea how Stubby actually snuck on board. But with all the soldiers milling around waiting to embark, there would have been plenty of opportunities for a little dog to hide up. Newport News is still an active naval base today, but in 1917 it was an important transport hub for soldiers heading to the war. More than 2 million troops were shipped out, and that required a lot of ships. Troop ships were crowded and uncomfortable, but they were the only way to get the boys over there. In between the US and France, there's more than 3,000 miles of ocean. And during the First World War, that ocean was infested with German submarines, or U-boats as they were called. They circled like sharks, just waiting to pounce on an unsuspecting troop ship. With a torpedo from beneath the waves, or a deck gun on the surface, a German U-boat could sink an Allied ship in minutes. It was essential that the crew stayed ever vigilant. The sinking of ships by U-boats began in 1915 with the passenger liner Lusitania, which was sunk off the Old Head of Kinsale, very close to our home studio in Ireland. Rescuers from Kinsale were some of the very first on the scene as news reached the little port. By placing adverts in US newspapers warning passengers not to travel, the Germans thought they'd done enough. However, they broke the rules by sending the Lusitania to the bottom of the ocean.
A torpedo, Captain! All the power now!
Yet we still hear the piteous cries of children coming out of the sea where the Lusitania went down. And Germany has never asked forgiveness of the world.
1,200 lives were lost, including many women and children. Although it was a further 2 years before the US entered the war in 1917, the sinking of the Lusitania was a compelling factor in the declaration of war. With all these perils circling in the deep ocean, keeping a lookout was essential. We'll never know how Conroy hid Stubby on the boat or for how long, but one day he was discovered by Major General Clarence Ransom Edwards. Responding to the encounter with his famous salute,
better salute, sir.
Stubby won over the general and was permitted to stay with the regiment.
There you go, Stubby. You're a real Yankee now.
When Stubby Conroy and the boys of the 102nd arrived in France, they weren't sent directly to the front. They spent another 2 months in training with the French army and learning about the enemy they'd be facing. Remember, most, if not all, of these young American soldiers had never left their state before. And here they were, thousands of miles from home, in a foreign country where they didn't speak the language, being dished up strange food. It wasn't until February of 1918 that the 102nd was ordered to the front. Along the way, they would have gotten a first-hand view of the destruction of the previous 3 years. It must have been a real shock.
They mean business. We need to stop them.
France was devastated by this war. And although many towns and villages have been rebuilt, you can still see the ruins of one or two that have been preserved as a reminder. I've tried to imagine myself in the boots of these young men as they trudged in with their little dog through the mud in the middle of the night to join their French allies at the front. But nothing could have prepared them for what they were about to see. Ahead, in the Pawprints of History, we're going to follow Stubby and the 102nd in their victorious march across France. We're going to be visiting the Chemin des Dames, where Stubby and his companions lived in the caves. We're going to be on the Chateau Thierry salient, where he received his iconic jacket, and at Seicheprey, where Stubby was wounded. We'll head to Marshville, where he caught a German spy and was made a sergeant in the US Army. And we'll finally finish up in the area around Verdun, where they were the night before the war ended.
We made it.